In today's video mini lecture, I'm going to talk about reality and variety television in Korea.
You've been paying attention to Korean media for a while, so you know that actually variety shows are a really integral part of the Korean entertainment industry. And they do form a role in shaping Korean society because they both reflect societal trends and they also are able to reinforce stereotypes and kind of order, like what is the way to do things, the correct way, the Korean way is reproduced. On the other hand, they don't have some of the attractive features that we've heard about in this class, that we know about in relation to K-dramas, like cliffhangers and amazing acting and really, really beautiful stars. All of that can be missing from these variety shows. So, yes, they still allow viewers to escape reality and they're lighthearted and they can be funny, but on the other hand, can we actually think that maybe the lack of good looks in the stars is allowing the members to come across as average and ordinary and therefore better able to reproduce Korean society? The Korean media industry is actually designed in a way to promote interdependence between music, drama, film, and variety. We see in Korean media a lot of intertextuality, a lot of intermediality, and K-variety is actually able to bank on the popularity of K-pop and K-drama by bringing those same idol stars and actors onto the variety shows as part of both getting viewers for the variety show, but also so that those singers and actors can promote themselves and promote their upcoming releases and somehow get closer to the viewing public. So, a lot of Korea's most popular variety shows are sketch comedies. Usually, when people talk about these shows, they talk a lot about Infinite Challenge, sometimes called Infinity Challenge, and Running Man. Sketch comedies are relatively unscripted, and so they can often feel much more real. So, in recent years, a lot of these Korean variety shows have been shooting more in foreign locations. They've been introducing other cultures, and this is really smart because there are a lot of Hallyu audiences already for Korean variety shows, and they want to know how they and their culture are seen within Korea, and so they can get glimpses of that through foreign location shooting. International audiences are often getting the K-variety through the internet. And this also means that they're creating these community of viewers, including fan subbing communities, as we've spoken about before. Interestingly, many of these K-variety shows lean heavily towards all male casts or mostly male casts. So women who appear in these shows, they're often idol stars, they're actresses, they may be coming on as a guest only for one or two episodes. And the male cast usually expresses fandom for these women. It expresses attraction to them. Now, if comedians or talents come on who are women, then they're often treated like brothers by the cast. So they're treated very differently. Now, the female stars who are actually fixed cast on variety shows are usually shown to be weak and feminine, reproducing some of the gender ideology in Korea, but at the same time, they are shown to have some sort of inner toughness that allows them to stick it together with the guys on the show. The gender ideology is also shown in the way that regular female cast members, such as Song Ji-hyo on Running Man, may be shown as unable to survive on the show without help from a male cast member. For a long time, that was Gary. Of course, he's no longer on the show. And there are also contrasts that are drawn between less masculine cast members and people like Kim Jong-guk, who are shown to be exceptionally hyper-masculine. One of the most important things about these variety shows is that they are aspirational because as we watch the shows, we see stars who are ordinary, but they are actually able to succeed in difficult challenges, and that demonstrates hope for ordinary Koreans who aren't famous. Oh, I also can achieve whatever if I continue to work hard. The shows also often feature Korean stories, performers, locations, and that allows them to promote nationalism and nationalistic sentiments. You know, we see things like Dokdo being taught through these variety shows. And it's actually easier to demonstrate some aspects of Korean culture through Korean variety shows than, for example, in K-pop. So these shows can be quite nationalistic, and they don't often include a lot of serious criticism or hard-hitting satire of the Korean government or official policies. So we see a lot of images, for example, of how Korea is a country that's both modernized and kept a hold of its own tradition at the same time. The way that shows like this tackle social issues can also be seen as a sort of working towards national consensus and common understanding of what the issues in the country are. It's amazing to me to think that now K-variety could be considered part of Hallyu in the same way that K-pop or K-dramas can be. So many of the Korean variety and reality television show formats have now been exported to other countries, not just within Asia, but in the United States and around the world.